Hey there, ready to hit the trails? A hike is the perfect opportunity to get up close and personal with all the different parts of earth science, especially rocks. These mountains are made of sandstone and shale. There are also some limestone caves nearby. And oh, see that reddish stuff by the river? That's clay, a type of sedimentary rock. It's kind of similar to the soil we're walking on, except, wait, now that I think about it, what's the deal with soil? It seems like it's too soft to be a rock, and there are all these little plant particles mixed into it. Sometimes you'll see pebbles in it, too. And soil must be different from dirt, right? After all, this whole forest isn't just growing in any old dirt, it's growing in soil. So, let's dig in and find out where this soil stuff comes from. By the end of this lesson, you'll be able to explain how weathering leads to both soil formation and erosion, compare and contrast mechanical weathering and chemical weathering, and identify factors that affect the rate of weathering. Let's get started. The Earth's surface is constantly being shaped by tons of different processes. Some, like earthquakes and volcanic eruptions, cause changes almost instantly. Others, like plate tectonics and erosion, take a long time. These slow processes are constantly at work, and over time, they can have some pretty incredible effects on our planet. One of these slow processes is called weathering. There are two different kinds of weathering, mechanical weathering and chemical weathering. Mechanical weathering is when rocks are physically broken down into smaller pieces. There are tons of different ways this can happen. The constant pressure from wind or moving water can chip away at rocks over time. Water can also get into cracks in the rock, then expand and push outwards when it freezes. Even plant roots can cause mechanical weathering by breaking stones apart. The important thing to remember about mechanical weathering is that while it breaks the rock apart, it doesn't change what the rock is made of. It basically just creates tiny pebbles and sediments of the same composition. Think of it like the world hitting a rock with a hammer, except the hammer is something like the wind or a river. All right, I admit, it's not a perfect metaphor, but you get it. So, that's mechanical weathering. On the other hand, chemical weathering can change a rock entirely. This is when rocks aren't just broken down, but their composition is also changed. Ever seen a piece of metal get rusty after it sits outside? That's an example of chemical weathering. The oxygen in the air actually caused the metal to undergo a chemical reaction, which changed its entire composition and broke it down in the process. Chemical weathering also occurs when rocks react with something like oxygen or water. Stalactites in caves are a perfect place to observe this. They form when minerals in cave rocks dissolve into water. Then the water drips down and leaves the buildup of minerals behind. Chemical and mechanical weathering both shape our planet in countless ways. Both chemical and mechanical weathering can involve some of the same forces, like air and water. The difference comes from how these forces break down rocks. Chemical weathering actually changes what the rock is made of, while mechanical weathering mostly just crushes it up. A few different things can affect how fast these processes happen, too. High temperatures result in rocks weathering faster than cold temperatures. Higher levels of rainfall and humidity do too. So, rocks in the hot, rainy tropics weather much faster than rocks in the cold, dry Arctic. Now, you might be wondering, if these processes are constantly occurring and breaking rock into tiny pieces, well, where do all those pebbles end up? And although it might surprise you, the answer is here. And everywhere, really. Every time you go for a hike outside, sit on the grass, or even plant a garden, you're seeing what the next step is for those weathered rocks. Soil. Mechanical weathering breaks rocks down into fine pieces that make up part of the soil. Chemical weathering breaks them down into the minerals that enrich the soil for plants and animals. Then, these pieces of weathered rock mix with water, gases from the atmosphere, decomposing organic matter, and microorganisms to make, you guessed it, soil. This mixture is what makes soil so unique and important. Without all of those pieces, it's just dirt. But weathering's role isn't over once rocks have become part of soil. The soil itself is continuously weathered too. This leads to erosion, when materials like rocks, minerals, or the soil they're all mixed up in are moved around by forces like wind and water. Unfortunately, the erosion of soil can cause lots of problems for the local environment. What kind of issues do you think can happen when soil is eroded? Pause the video here and write down your thoughts in your guided notes. Soil is essential to life on Earth. When it's eroded away, plants can't get the nutrients they need to grow, which means animals can't get the plants they need for food either. Without soil to hold them in place, rocks and dirt from deeper underground are often also eroded, which can clog up rivers with extra sediment. Plus, soil is very absorbent. Without this layer to soak up all the rain, areas start to flood more easily. Of course, once these soils are eroded away, that still isn't the end of their story. Since soil is a sediment, it'll eventually be cemented and compacted back into sedimentary rocks. This is a natural cycle, but it can still be a problem for farmers, forests, and animals in the meantime. Yep, there's no doubt soil is essential for life on Earth, and it takes quite a few processes to create this amazing stuff. So, let's recap what we've learned today. Now you know that weathering creates soil by breaking down rocks, and the same forces cause erosion. Factors like temperature and rainfall can impact the rate of weathering. And mechanical weathering involves breaking a rock down, while chemical weathering changes its composition. Be sure to check out the engaging games and thought-provoking practice activities to get ready for our next lesson, where we'll learn more about how erosion impacts our planet. And in the meantime, remember, in earth science, as in life, you rock! See you next time. Hey, hey.